The PlayStation VR 2 is Sony's second attempt at a virtual reality headset, and it's a substantial improvement on the original. Sony sent me a review sample of the PSVR 2, so I spent the last week testing the new VR headset. Here are my thoughts. The PlayStation VR 2 features a halo design, with a plastic band snugly wrapping around my head. Despite featuring a padded headband, I did find the tight clamp of the headset to become uncomfortable after an hour or so of use. You can at least adjust the fit via a dial at the back, as well as moving the front visor forward or backwards, which will be a blessing for those who wear glasses. Haptic feedback technology is built into the headset, giving your head a little buzz when a dinosaur crashes into the ground or when you discover a collectible in the adorable platform game Moss. I'm a big fan of this feature, vibrations proving subtle enough that they didn't cause any discomfort, although you are able to turn this feature off if you prefer. Unlike the original headset, the PSVR 2 only requires a single USB-C cable to plug into the PS5. That means you're able to start playing immediately, as long as you've already finished the eye tracking setup and created your designated playing space. But that single cable can still get in the way. I tripped over it a number of times during play, making me pine for more wireless freedom afforded by the Meta Quest 2 and Pico 4. Being tethered to the PS5 also made it more difficult to find a suitable play space for the VR. On the upside, leveraging the power of the PS5 console allows for visually stunning worlds. I'll never forget the first time stepping into the incredibly detailed jungle of Horizon Call of the Mountain, offering far more gorgeous vistas than what the Quest 2 can create when running solo. The PSVR 2's OLED display certainly helps to make colours look more vibrant too, whether it was the lush green vegetation or the fiery blast of a bellow-backed machine. The 4K resolution also ensures crisp imagery, with the screen door effect still just about visible, but only if you squint. Despite supporting up to 120Hz refresh rate, I did occasionally notice some juddery visual effects from fast-moving objects at a distance, but it wasn't frequent enough to impact the high level of immersion. Performance is superb. The headset was able to offer pinpoint accuracy through its inside-out cameras, with no other external sensors required. The fantastic sense controllers also allow me to mimic real-world actions, whether it's pulling the string of a bow or slamming a pickaxe into the wall to scale up a mountain. Haptic feedback is built into these controllers too, so I could feel the tension of a bow when aiming. The sense controllers use a USB-C connection for power delivery, and each lasts around 4.5 hours of game time on a single charge. That's not a huge amount of stamina, but I doubt many people would want to be immersed in virtual reality for that long. The lineup of PSVR 2 games is decent at launch, but mostly made up of ports from other headsets such as the Meta Quest. It's also a big shame that there's no backwards compatibility here, forcing you to rebuild your library from scratch and making the likes of Astrobot Rescue Mission inaccessible. The big star is undoubtedly Horizon Call of the Mountain, which is the best VR game I've played yet, alongside Half-Life Alyx. Horizon feels like a full-length adventure rather than a shallow arcade experience, showing the high potential of what the PSVR 2 can offer. I do hope more games utilise features such as eye tracking in the future, as the innovative technology was sadly only used for menu navigation in Horizon. This technology likely drove up the cost of the headset too, with a $549 price likely too high to stomach for most gamers. The PlayStation VR 2 is a fantastic VR headset, with all the specs required to deliver wonderfully immersive experiences. The streamlined setup process and more intuitive controllers also make it a massive upgrade on the original headset. The PSVR 2's success will depend heavily on its game library. If PlayStation can keep launching games to the same standard of Horizon Call of the Mountain, then there's no doubt in my mind that it'll become the best VR headset on the market. Otherwise, it's hard not to be tempted by the wireless and more affordable Meta Quest. For that reason, I gave a PlayStation VR 2 a 4 out of 5 rating. If you want a more in-depth analysis of PlayStation VR 2, then check out our full review on the Trust Reviews website. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like and subscribe buttons. Thanks for watching.